chapter 3 na. Last Sunday I brought you all the way up to verse 11. This morning we will continue verse 12 to 14, but we will read again from verse 1 na, because as I see it, this is one flow of what Paul was writing na, in this portion of his letter. So Colossians 3 verse 1 to 14 ang basahon natin liwat sa sininga aga. Okay, let's all stand as we honor God's word. So I'll be reading again from the ESV version. If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you: sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming. In these you too once walked, when you were living in them. But now you must put them all away: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and obscene talk from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have put off the old self with its practices, and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. Here there is not Greek and Jew, circumcised and uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave, free, but Christ is all and in all. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all this, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Lord, we thank you for this day again, a day of rest for us, a day where our hearts once again can rest in you as we gather together as your body, setting our minds and hearts on things that are above, Lord. We pray that as we continue to worship you, as our hearts are bowed down to you in this moment, that we may hear your word, Lord, and that we may become doers of your word. Father, we pray for such a mighty move of the Holy Spirit, that your word will truly transform us and renew our minds and our hearts and bring a change, Lord, that comes from you. So we are trusting in you. Even this morning we are praying that there are those who will be born again. Even those of us who thought that we have been Christian for so long, may the Holy Spirit work in a way that will open our hearts to who you are and what you are doing. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Let me just bring you through a review of sorts. No? Okay. Kung manotice nyo sa verse 1 to 14, put off, put to death, put off. Tapos put on ang pinakalast. Amo niyang focus naton karon. No? But this is what Paul was talking about. He was talking about the life that we were to live as Christians. As I mentioned last Sunday, this is still in relation to our not being deceived. Why? Because some of us Christians don't realize, but the world tries to deceive us with regards to the life or the lifestyle that we are to live. Deception, gyapon. Deception is not just doctrine. It's not just about false teaching. It's about the false life that the world offers. No? Kitatanan. All of us grew up in this world. All of us grew up with this understanding of how we are to live, how we are to talk, how we are to treat our marriage, how we are to deal with other people, no? How to react in certain circumstances. So diri gina plastar na ni Pablo. No? How is it that a believer should live? But this life is also based on knowledge, the knowledge of Christ, on who He is, what He has done, and how that affects our life. That's what differentiates Christianity from morality. Christianity is not just morality. Christianity is not trying hard to do what we're supposed to do. Okay? Diba ang usual concept natin is, oh, ginhatag ni Lord ang Ten Commandments. Dapat gali, eh, gina-obey natin. Okay? Of course, the answer there is always, can you try? Sige nga, i-try nyo, i-obey ang commandments. We will always fail. There is something that God has to do for us to become His people. Basically, Paul said in verse 1 to 11 that we have been raised with Christ. Okay? We have been raised with Christ. If you are a true Christian, that believer realizes that he was dead. Okay? We were dead in our transgressions and sins. We see that in Ephesians 2, verse 1. Patay kita spiritually. We were dead. But when we put our faith in Christ, okay, we were made alive with Christ. That was a working of God. No? It's not a working of man. We have been raised to new life just as Christ was raised from the dead. Okay? Amen to that? Let's turn to Romans 6 very quickly. Review lang kita. No? Romans 6, when Paul brought up the issue, shall we continue in sin? Diba? Verse 1, what shall we say then? Are we to continue in sin so that grace may abound? O para mas grabe pagid ang grasya ni Lord. Te kung magpadayon kita sa sin, te mas nami ang grasya ni Lord. And Paul said, by no means. How can we who died to sin still live in it? See? Amo na ang understanding sang isa ka believer. In Christ, I have died to sin. And you notice, you don't even need someone to teach you that doctrine. When your heart has been changed, all of a sudden you realize that there is something wrong about your past life. There is something wrong with things that you are doing. It's the Holy Spirit who convicts us. Not a religion, not a person. It's the Holy Spirit. All of us died to sin. Verse 3, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into His death? We were buried therefore with Him by baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. So the new life that we are living is all a result of who Christ is. And when we put our faith in Him, the same death and resurrection that Christ went through happens also to us spiritually. Okay? So, because we have been raised with Christ, okay, let's go back to Colossians, verse 1. The ESV says, seek the things that are above. We are raised with Christ. Where is Christ now? He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He is above. And so as believers, we are to seek the things that are above. The NIV adds the word heart. If you look at the NIV version, since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above. All of a sudden, a believer's heart is set on the things that are above. Now, this is also a warning in a sense. Why? Kasi kita, no, mga believers, tao lang ta. We're still in this world. And our tendency is to seek the things of the world. Our hearts are still in the things of the world. Diba? The desires, the motives, everything is still in the world. And Paul is reminding them, if you have been raised with Christ, do not seek the things of earth. This is not to consume our hearts. Now, this does not mean, amo na ang asceticism, eh. This does not mean that you run to the mountains and live away from society. This does not mean na ilak mo ang imong kaugalingon sa imong balay, kag hindi ka na maglantaw TV. Kag. No, it's talking about seeking. Your heart does not seek these things anymore. Your heart seeks the things that are above. See, and again, this is a working of the Holy Spirit. You realize that. So we seek, our hearts seek what is above. Okay? It becomes only natural for us as those who have been raised with Christ, who have been given a new life, to begin thinking of the things of God. You notice the connection with Paul's prayer in chapter 1? His prayer was that God would fill us with what? The knowledge of what? Okay, let's go back to Colossians 1. Okay, connectado ni siya, brethren. Paul prayed in Colossians 1, verse 9, and so from the day we heard, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. Hindi na ang ways ng kalibutan, Lord. There's something wrong with this world. I need to seek your ways. Seek your life. Okay? Everything. So, verse 10, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. Okay? Once again, okay, it becomes natural for a true believer to seek the things from above. Why? Because this is not something that is being forced, or we're not being coerced or manipulated, or ginakulit kita sang isa ka church or sang isa ka pastor na dapat amunin ka buhay. Hindi. It is all a working of God in our hearts. He has given us new life. And this is what Paul continues in verse 2. He says, set your minds on things that are above, not on the things that are on earth. Now, importante ang mind, brethren. Now, why? Because a Christian doesn't just do things blindly. No? We just don't do things by faith. No? Ay, hindi na ako manigarilyo. Ay, hindi na ako mainom. Why? Why? Basta. Okay, Christian ako eh. Wala ka understanding. No, you need to have the understanding. Why are you not doing that? Why are you putting them to death? Why are you taking them off? Why are you putting on? It's about the mind. Okay? A Christian does not just walk blindly by faith. No. We understand who God is, who Christ is, why He wants us to teach. And our minds begin to seek the things also that are above, not on earth. Okay? Notice our minds. Ang mindset natin, brethren. Okay? It doesn't mean that we don't do the things of the world. It doesn't mean that we enjoy the things of the world. But our mind is always thinking of what is God. What is God's will? Of who is God? And what God's will is. We're always thinking, Lord, ano bang will mo para sa akin? Ano bang gusto mo sa akin, Lord? We're always thinking of God. Okay? In fact, I always, at least in my own experience, I don't know about you, but do you find yourself praying in the morning and saying, Lord, anong isuksok ko subong? Diba? It may sound so trivial, no? And so corny. Biska ng bayo na isuksok mo, gina-pray mo kay Lord, pero amo ng mindset mo eh. Daw ang pamatsag mo, Lord, at tanan. Diba? Ang tanan, everything is of God. Everything is God's will. And that should be the mind that we have. Our minds are not seeking the things of this world. Our reasoning is not the things of this world. Our understanding is not the things of this world. So many examples I can share with you, no? Pero amo nang namitani na may ka-fellowship ka mo, no? Talking about Colossians, because what does it mean to set our minds on things above, diba? So you know, when you talk about family, when you talk about husbands and wives, when you talk about business, when you talk about work, no? I mentioned before, someone corrected me when I said that, you know, when you're seeking for advice for business, do not go to yung mga tag-iasang Apple or ang tag-iasang Microsoft. Okay? Now, of course, when it comes to business matters, now, of course, you can learn things from them. But when it comes to the heart, when it comes to the motive, because all of these people, everything they're doing is for money. Everything they're doing is for success. Everything they're doing is for themselves. Ano ang sa Ginoo? What is God's purpose in work? What is God's purpose for your business? What is God's purpose in your life? Even for marriage. Even for, let's say, with our children. Okay. Yesterday I was pleasantly surprised because with the Lord, okay, I had a child dedication yesterday, and you know, usually you look for verses that talk about family, you know, children, you go back to Jesus and Mary, etc., Proverbs, no, and everything. But the word that it, you know, and sadly when it comes to child dedications, I don't know, you know, the people are not as attentive as you want them to be. Pero I was surprised in the passage the Lord gave me in regards to dedication of a child. You know what that passage was? Matthew chapter 29. Okay. Na-check nyo ba? 28, verse 18 to 20. Okay. It says, "All authority," Jesus said, "has been given to me. Therefore, go and build your family." Ay, hindi gali. Ano nakasulat? "Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, teaching them all that I have commanded you. And lo," Jesus said, "I will be with you." You know how many of us parents never connected that with family? Di ba? Okay. Ako, I will confess, the beginning of my family, I never connected it as discipleship. But parents need to realize that when God gives us children, He calls us to disciple them. Why? Because every part of our life is part of the Great Commission. Hindi lang ministry ng church. Hindi lang nag-member ka sa isa ka discipleship group. Everything we are doing is all part of discipling one another. No? And yung ginparealize ni Lord sa ako na, sabi ko, grabe Lord, no? I need to talk to the parents of whom I, you know, dedicated children. I need to remind them that that's our call to disciple. Diba? And parents are called to share the authority of Christ with their children. They're called to teach their children what Jesus has commanded up to the time when their child can make a decision for themselves. And that's the step of faith there, because not all our children automatically follow the Lord. Diba? Pero ginausar ni Lord, brethren, ang pag-disciple natin. Those of us who still have young children, diba? We need to remember that. We're called to disciple. Husbands and wives are called to disciple one another. Diba? And the rest of the church, we have to go back to that mindset seeking. See, that's what God changes. Ang mindset sa pagtulok natin sa kabuhay natin diri sa kalibutan. God changes all of that. So this seeking, no, things that are above, setting our minds on things that are above continuously, brethren. It never stops. That's why we need to continue to grow in the Word, because it never stops, brethren. Okay? And what was Paul's point here? Baliktad sa Colossians chapter 3. Set your mind on things above. Okay? Why? Kasi Paul said it in verse 3, "For you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God." Our life now is hidden with Christ. We are now in Christ. And so you seek the things that are above. Have you noticed how religion becomes so dangerous? Okay? That we have a religion of Christianity, tapos pag-abot sa ito ng kabuhi, kanya-kanya na eh. Oh, diba? We do what we want, we run after what we want, we live how we want, pero sa Sunday, arita sa church. Sa Bible study, nag-a-attend kita. May discipleship pa. But then when it comes to life, we're not in Christ. We're not with God. We're on our own. But that's completely alien from what the Word of God shows us. Our life is hidden with Christ in God. And then Paul says in verse 4, when Christ, who is your life, notice how the Holy Spirit has to change our mindset. Christ is our life. He's not just God. He's not just the one we worship. Hindi lang siya religion. Siya gid ang nakon nga kabuhi. Siya. And when He appears, Paul said, you also will appear with Him in glory. Now notice, Paul brings us to the future. Christ is going to appear. Okay? So what is God doing? Okay? For those of us who are in Christ, you see? He's going to continually change us and transform us so that when He comes, we will be like Him. Okay? perfectly when we're in eternity. Pero diri sa aton nga kabuhi, God continually works that. That's why a Christian changes. Not because amo ni ang stand sang church, amo ni ang role. No, it's because God, because our life is hidden with God. And we're awaiting His appearance. When He returns, I want to be like Him. This is the new life that God is recreating in us. You see that we see that in verse, what do you call this? Verse 9 and 10. Do not lie to one another, saying that you have put off the old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. Okay? That was, last, kung makonfess ko sa inyo, okay, some of you don't believe this every time you come to me and say, grabe ang word of God, pastor, no? Ang sabat ko pirmi, grabe gid, kaya ako ang unang ginkwan. Naging ego sang word of God. Can you imagine what God is doing with regards to the new self? Diba? I shared that with you last Sunday. Diba? When God created man in Genesis 1 and in Genesis chapter 2, it was a good creation. Very good gani ang hambal ni Lord. God even gave him a perfect garden. Diba? Four rivers flowing into it. Grabe ang abundance. Sang garden. It was God's garden. God put the man there. God breathed into the man the breath of life. Can you imagine that life that God gave man? Huh? Kung hindi nagsala si Adan, can you imagine what kind of life we would be living today? We would literally be living in paradise. Diba? Why? Kasi okay ang tanan eh. Everything was beautiful. Everything was perfect until man disobeyed the word of God. Disobeyed the word. And because of that, grabe ang curse sa aton. Diba? Grabe ang curse. But what is, look at verse 10. What is God doing with this new self that He is giving us? He is renewing the new self. Okay? Not the old self. The old self dies. The new self that God gives us, He is renewing it in the image of who? It's creator. Okay? So, ginabaliktan ni Lord sa chapter 1 and 2 sang Genesis. Can you imagine that? It's not going to be overnight. But isn't this something that you long for? Diba? Na Lord, buwas, or karon sang hapon, after sang service, Lord, padayon lang ang pag-renew mo sa akon. I want to see this new self that you are renewing in me. Kagtani makita gid sa akon nga kabuhi. I pray that I see it in my life. Diba? And that's why people will begin to notice. Okay? Not because you're following a religion, but they begin to notice a change that God Himself is bringing. And people will not, okay, or cannot not see it. Nakuha nyo? Correct grammar ba na? People cannot not see it. Okay? Nakuha nyo naman yung punto ko. Kasi si Lord na nag-work eh. Diba? He Himself is changing you. Eh. And so people will wonder, diba? What's wrong with you? What's happening with you? Nga daw nagabago ang imong life. Ay, sa amon nga religion kasi. Sa amon nga religion, bawal lang amon eh. Bawal lang amon na. No? Hindi kami mag-touch sina. Hindi kami magkaon sina. Is that your answer? No. Your answer is, you know what? I don't really understand, but God is working in my heart. He's changing. And His Word is the one that is transforming us. And that's why Paul said, you see, with this new life that God is has given us, what did Paul tell them in verse 5? Put to death. Okay. Can you sense the tone of this pagsulat ni Paul? We can only sense it, and you know? We can't really see Paul eh, while he was writing it, or kung ano ang unod sa mind niya. Hindi siya put to death, di ba? I-try nyo lang. Palihog. O, di ba? Hindi. Put to death. O, di ba? Patyon mo ang mga inigaputang. They should not be there. Di ba? And every time we do it again, ang Kristiyano, init sa iyang kakuli ko, na, naman Lord, kagigim mo ko ni Lord, kasi put to death dapat eh. Okay? And you keep on putting it to death until it dies. That's the tone that I see there. Seryoso ka na niya. Hindi yung, just try. No. All of these things, sexual immorality, okay? Look at it says in verse 5. Sexual immorality, impurity, passion, grabe, no? Evil desires, and covetousness. Okay? Why? Okay. Now, the idolatry there, okay, because of the word is, okay, seems to be focused only on covetousness. But I think it's obvious that anything that takes you away from God, that takes the place of God controlling you. Okay, that's why, yes, sexual immorality and passions. Okay, remember I talked about Shopee, di ba? Yung mga payday special, di ba? You know, this is how the world likes to excite us about the payday special. Gamitin mo ang video card mo para pa, no, di ba? Baklon mo ang hindi mo kinanglan. Amo nang style sa advertising eh. Okay, that's why dapat halong ka mo eh. I came from that. I studied it. I actually did it, di ba? You don't need it, but buy it, di ba? Amen? Okay, wala nag-amen. Okay? But these passions, they control us. That's why it's idolatry. Sexual immorality. Have you ever noticed that? Yung mga lalaki diri, nasa una, no? May ara ka mo extracurricular activity. Di ba? May asawa ka na, nangita ka pa iban. Because it's so hard to stop sexual immorality. Di ba? Once you've done it, you have to do it again. That's why sex was only meant for husband and wife. Why? It binds them together. See? The moment you practice it, with either before or after, wala na, nakagapos ka na. Sa Tagalog, kagapos, nakatali ka na, nakahigot ka na sa sinangasin. It's idolatry. Passions are idolatry. Diba? Everything that's written there, evil desires. Okay? That's why kanamis ang paghambal ni Paul na covetousness is idolatry, but all of these things, they're idolatry. Okay? Now, why idolatry? Remember what Paul told us in chapter 2? Christ is in you. Diba? The image of the invisible God, the fullness of the deity found in Christ, He is actually in you. So kung may lain nga Diyos na nagsulod sa imo nga heart, napatpatsyon mo siya. Hindi mo himuon pet. Diba? Christian ako. Kabalo ko nga ang passions. Dapat i-control po. I-control ko. Pero kanamis ang feeling na may kwarto ko pambakal sa mga butang na hindi ko kinanglan. Di ba? Kanamis ang feeling eh. Right? It's a nice feeling to know that you have money to spend. Okay? I don't know how many of you will agree with me. Okay? That's why when you're in abundance, blessing ni Lord, they're excited. But you know what? That's why, you know, we have to make sure that they're not idols eh. And that's why you come back to your God. Lord, how do I spend my money? Diba? Baklon ko sa bago nga kuan sa lakyan or ibutang ko sa building fund. No, diba? And our logic will tell us, ano nga ibuot sa building fund? Tapos namin may bago nga sa lakyan. Diba? We sometimes we don't set our minds on things above. Eh. Diba? We automatically think of ourselves. Right? Example lang na. I'm not saying that that's what you should do. But that's just an example of how we set our minds on things above. The time, the things that I do there, they're idolatry. The fullness of the deity is in us. Okay. Turn with me to Exodus 32. When God sent Moses to the mountain to be given the commandments, no? Not just the 10 commandments, if you look at it, di ba? Pero, so many commandments, especially about the tabernacle. No? You know how the book of Exodus ends? Okay? The book of Exodus ends with the tabernacle, with the presence of God dwelling with His people. That's why He brought them out of Egypt. Not just for a promised land. He brought them out of his people so that of Egypt so that they would be his people and that he would tabernacle with them. Basahin niyo ang last part ng Exodus. It talks about the presence of God that was so great that the people could not even look at it. That was God's point in Exodus. It was not ang duta. Hindi. It was Him. Okay? When God sent Moses to the mountain, verse 1, chapter 32, when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down from the mountain, the people gathered themselves together to Aaron and said to him, "Up, make us gods who shall go before us. As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we do not know. What has become of him?" So Aaron, si Aaron naman, okay, sunod naman siya. Okay? Na peer pressure siya. Kuno, amo nang hambal niya. Okay? So they made all of these gods. Okay? Now let's just fast forward to verse 25. Okay? "And when Moses saw that the people had broken loose, for Aaron had let them break loose to the derision of their enemies, then Moses stood in the gate of the camp and said, 'Who is on the Lord's side? Come to me.' And all the sons of Levi gathered around him. And he said to them, 'Thus says the Lord God of Israel, put your sword on your side, each of you, and go to and fro from gate to gate throughout the camp. And each of you, look at this, brethren, kill his brother and his companion and his neighbor.' And the sons of Levi did according to the word of Moses. And that day about 3,000 men of the people fell. And Moses said, 'Today you have been ordained for the service of the Lord, each one at the cost of his son and at the end of his brother, so that he might bestow a blessing upon you today.'" Okay? You know, some people wonder why is it in the Old Testament that God commanded to kill? Okay? You know what the answer is? At least with his people, is his holiness. They did not see his holiness. They did not recognize. They made idols for themselves. Idols that they saw in Egypt. That's why ang calf ang ginpangitan nila. Okay? And what did the Lord tell Moses to do? Put them to death. Okay? Today, we do not do that in the church. Di ba? Amen ba? Kung hindi, walang buhi sa ito. Biskan ako siguro, basi ako unaw niyo patyon. Eh. Di ba? Where do we do it here? Di ba? You have been given a new self. I'm bringing you back to Genesis 1 and 2. Ang tanan nga idols na ara sa inyong heart, put them to death. Ang bal ni Paul. Put them to death. Why? Because of the new self. That's what God has been telling His people from Exodus, from Genesis. I am holy. I am a jealous God. Okay? That's where jealousy becomes right with God. Okay? Why? Kasi nagseselos si Lord sa mga iba na Diyos na aras sa aton na heart. Grabe, no? If we walk with that understanding every day, brethren, when you are tempted with sexual immorality, passion, evil desires, okay, you realize. Okay, you realize. And this is where so many of these sins come. You know, some of you heard me share this, di ba? So my son asked me, si Paul, sabi niya, "Dad, oh, ginalegalize na marijuana." Eh. They know my testimony. Okay? Marijuana was a cigarette for me. I did not smoke cigarettes. For a while lang ako nagsigarilyo. Pero ang marijuana ko, everyday, kid. Okay? Everyday. And he said, "What? Oh, legalize na that? Medicinal. Oh, di ba? Will you go back to using it? Legal na eh. Di ba? Just because a country legalizes marijuana or shabu or whatever it is, does that mean that a Christian will do it? Why? Because if it controls you. See, that's the point about drugs. Eh. That's the point about cigarettes. That's the point about wine. If it controls you, it becomes your idol. Hindi pangitao ng din ang do not smoke cigarettes dire. Ang marijuana, di ba, basi gin-create man ni Lord sa Genesis? O, di ba? Okay, di ba, ang tanan nga plants gin-create ni Lord? O, di ba? Amen ba? Ang point ng Genesis, hindi makabalo ang opium galing gin-create ni Lord kaga marijuana gin-create, okay, no? No, the whole point of creation was to focus us on God, not creation. Okay? Have you noticed how we use that example? Yung marijuana naman eh. Ay, nga nagatulog ako da. No, marijuana ang itsura. Okay? So anyway, okay. See? No, it's about the idolatry of these things. Ask yourself, those who are still, if you're still smoking, fine, we're not gonna judge you, di ba? We check your fingers kung may nicotine. Di lang kamo kabalo, pero parts ang temperature sa gwa, gina-check ba ng nicotine sa kwan. So anyway, joke lang na, okay? So anyway, we don't check you for that. No. But ask yourself, who really controls my life? Is it drugs? Is it cigarettes? Is it money? Is it sex? Is it my passion? Di ba? For something? Do you know what an idol is? One idol in America? Do you know what it is? It is Sunday football. Okay? Yung football nila. Okay? Yung, anong tawag na sa kwan? Pinaka-championship pa nila. The? Super Bowl. Okay, hindi ko mind, naka-muffle lang inyong kwan eh. You know, during the Super Bowl, how many Christians do not go to worship because of the Super Bowl? Timing, Sunday, gid nila gina-schedule per me. Okay? So that's why for many Christians, it's an idol. Grabe, no? We just need to check. Okay? Anything that takes away the sovereignty and control of the Lord over our lives. It could be your husband or your wife. It could even be your children who are your idols. Oh, yes. Diba? You're bringing them up in a way para pag nagdako sila, they will be the pride of our family. No? And so, biskan hindi sila nag-gapati kay Lord. Biskan hindi sila na-born again. Ang importante, CEO siya. Diba? You notice ang Pilipino? Ang importante, mag-maranon siya, maging successful siya. Hindi pwede, hindi bali, mapa-impyerno siya. Hindi na, importante na. Diba? Ang importante, makatapos siya mag-aral, may nami siya katrabaho, bahala na siya kung hindi siya nag-pray or nag-attend sa... Oh, notice how many of you still have that crazy idea. Yan, diretsahan na. No, you should be telling your child, it doesn't matter what happens to your college or whatever. Diba? What shall it profit a man? What did Jesus say? Do I have to continue? What shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and yet loses his soul? Anak nga, hasta subog sa Jollibee ka lang nag-aubra. Anak, anak naman. O, diba? Tani, McDo. At least. And then we have to, diba? Set your minds on things above. Hindi ang problema. Anong problema na nag-map siya? Okay? Kung nag-grow siya kay Lord, kung si Lord ang may control siya ang kabuhi. Anak, paano ka mag-asenso, anak? Di ba? Hindi lang anak eh. Honey, naano ka man, darling. Di ba? Naano ka man. Tari lang. Di ba? You saw that post I shared sa Lampstand Facebook. If a wife questions how the husband provides, she is actually questioning how God is providing. I don't know kung nakita nyo. Basi, nagpikit ka mo, parang hindi. Okay. If a wife questions how her husband provides, she is actually questioning God. Ano ba mindset nyo? Na ang bana nyo ang naghahatag kwarta sa kwan, sa inyong family? Ang bana nyo ba? Or si Lord? Oh. So kinanglan ba? Million-million? Or nagatulog ka kay Lord? Set your minds on things above. Diba? Put to death the idols of your life. Okay? Now we're all guilty of that. Huh? You go through Exodus, brethren. You know what the first response of your heart is, Lord, salamat kay Jesus Christ. Kay kung hindi, isa ako da. Naging patay sa mga Levites. Diba? Because all of us have idols in our hearts. We just have to put them to death. Diba? Don't shampoo them and pet them and nagabutan ka pa perfume para ka namin. No, put it to death. Okay? Put it to death. And then, Paul continues. Verse 7, in these two you once walked when you were living in them, but now Look what Paul says. You must put them all away. That's verse 8. But now you must put them all away. You know that phrase, put them all away, or in the NIV, rid yourselves, get rid of them. In the Greek, you know what it means? It means to not wear it any longer. No, kanami sa connection sa sulat ni Paul eh. Do not wear it anymore. Get rid of it. Okay? Put them all away. What? Anger. Oh, grabe na. Sinong hindi guilty? Di ba? Anger. Okay? Now, this does not mean that we cannot get angry. Because there are many Christians na high blood sila kaya ginapugong nilang anger nila. Hindi. Dapat mangakig ta. Pero dapat bantayan mo kung paano ka nagapangakig. No, di ba? Does this mean na you will not discipline your child? Discipline your child. If you have an employee, may business ka, ang employee mo nagsala, dapat ba? Oh, sige, next time ha. No, akigan mo sila. But there's a way to get angry without sinning. Okay? It's a combination of all of these things. Anger, okay? Actually, the Greek word for anger here is actually a word that is used for vengeance. So, grabe gid na akig, di ba? Na, no, naman ginula. Halimbawa, may negosyo ka, no? Shawarma, halimbawa. Okay? Tapos ginula niya ang kwa ng bowls ng beef. No, no, kama, no. Ay, bawa sa sweldo mo. Di ba? Grabe, ang volume, ha. Biskan ako, nakibot. Anyway, it's that kind of anger ba na, daw ginapatay mo ng tao? Di ba? That's why humble ni James, eh, di ba? Ang anger. Si Lord actually, pero si James, ginkwan niya, ang anger. No murder. Eh. Oh, di ba? Kasi daw nakapatay ka tao. Wrath! What is wrath? Okay? Arata, di ba? It's, of course, I think we all know what wrath is, di ba? Fierceness. So connected siya. No? When you have anger, you express it in a fierce way. Di ba? Have you ever... ako, guilty ako. Ginabasa ko lang, guilty na ako. Di ba? But you have to put them all away. Okay? There's something about anger and wrath. Di ba? Malice. Okay? Evil. Ang malicia sa imong thoughts. Okay? Have you ever gotten angry at someone that you wanted you not to kill them? No? Sa Tagalog, ang joke namin dyan, sana madapaka. Madapaka sana. Di ba? Madasma or gusto mo may masama na matabo sa iya, wala, no? That's the kind of thinking na gina-mention dito. Slander. Diba? Blasphemy. Evil. Ay, nako, brethren. It's election time again. Okay? Please don't get yourself caught in the stupidity of the slander that people are talking about politicians. Halo ka mo mga Kristiyano, ginabantayan ko ang inyong Facebook. I-unfriend nyo na lang ako kung hindi nyo gusto. Tuwad-to. That's why I'm in Facebook. I don't like Facebook. But I'm there because I have to guard you. Unfriend me if you want. I don't care. But if, you know, if you don't agree with the politician, fine. Of course, we can, di ba? But does it have to lead to malice and slander? Does it have to go to that? Okay? Eh, kita, mga, hindi kita, we're not setting our minds on things above. Okay? We're so pushing our candidates as if that's the hope of our nation. Ano ba, what kind of mindset do you have? Na ang politiko, ang paglaom sa aton nga syudad o nasyon? Ano ba? Diba? It's not eh. Have the right mind. And who are we to slander? We may not agree with them. And there can be a reason, but a Christian puts off that's the old self. Who are you to slander anyone? Oh, di ba? We live in an age where it's all right to slander. It's not. It is not all right. I'm not saying you don't have a candidate who you agree with. Fine. Okay? But when you give your life and saliva to ruin someone else just so your candidate will win, ganun ba yun? Okay? May old self ka ba? May new self ba naging butang ni Lord? Do you recognize that in your heart? Or are you still part of this world? Obscene talk from your mouth. Vile or filthy communication. Let the Holy Spirit deal that with you. This is not just about politics, di ba? You know, when you're, you notice how all of it is daw konektado siya sa anger, di ba? You notice when you're angry with someone, you begin to talk bad about that person, put them down, even if it's someone you love. Di ba? Even if it's someone you love. Why? Kasi nga, ano eh, pride siya eh. Okay? It's pride. Do not lie to one another. Di ba? Of course, the joke always there is, how old are you? Ah, joke lang. Pag babae ang ginapamagot mo, medyo, di ba? That's not what it's talking about. Lying here means to deceive by falsehood. You're deceiving someone. Okay? Okay? So there are some who jokingly lie about their age. Jokingly lang, di ba? Pero ang pinakamotivo mo, mag-deceive. Eh, di ba? Brand new ba na ang imo produkto? Brand new, di ba? Pero ginusar mo na, actually, di ba? Pero gina-deceive mo ang tao. Amo na ang lying. You see? When this, ambal ni Paul, do not lie to one another. Okay? Why? Okay. Because we have put off the old self. Do we recognize as Christians, I mentioned this last time, that there's an old self and a new self? Do you recognize that there's a new self that God, di ba part din siya sa ginatawag nato na Ten Commandments? One of the most that is quoted, di ba? Do not lie. Do not give false testimony. Do not lie. And yet how natural it is, di ba, for us to lie. Di ba? Grabe, no? But we have put off the old self with its practices, verse 9, and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge after the image of its creator. Put to death, put off, stop wearing it. Dapat hindi makita sa, we need to be conscious about it because we're surrounded with so many circumstances that bring us to that understanding. Diba sa home pa lang eh, right? Husband and wife eh. You know, in the family, we are so comfortable with each other that sometimes we think it's all right just to speak what we want to speak with them. Pag nagapangakig ta, asawa ko naman siya. Bana ko naman siya. Hindi. Okay? Oh, you're a new creation. That's why, let's continue now. Let's continue with put on, verse 12. And that's why Paul continues and says, put on then. So, you know this, brethren, the Christian life is not just about putting to death. It's not just about putting off. It's also about putting on. So in other versions, it's clothe yourself, sa NIV. Okay. So you take off what you're not supposed to wear and you wear what you are supposed to live. Put on then. Okay. Put on then as God's chosen ones. Holy and beloved. Compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another. And if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also try to forgive. Okay? Try ba nakasulat? Okay? Ano kasulat? Must. Okay? Grabe, no? Again, kita nyo ang seriousness of the tone of Paul's letter? This is not good advice. No. Put it on. Okay? Notice how okay, God asks us to clothe ourselves. Okay? Sa NIV na, going back to verse 12 gali, Zion sa NIV, di ba? Clothe yourselves. Now, you notice what God is doing? Notice what Paul is talking about here? He's talking about an old self, napatay. He talks about a new self that God gives us when we are born again. It's being renewed to its creator. Here, God is telling us, Paul is telling us to clothe ourselves. Okay? Where is the first story of the Bible where God clothes someone? Do you know that? Kabalo ko masiguro, no? Hindi siya. Sa Genesis. Okay? Turn with me to Genesis chapter 3. Okay. In Genesis chapter 3, after all the anger and cursing, di ba? First, when Adam and Eve sinned in verse 7, look what they tried to do. Sang pagsala ni Adan kag ni Eva. It says there in verse 7, then the eyes of both of them were opened. Okay, I'm reading from the NIV. The eyes of both of them were opened and they realized they were naked. Okay. You know that in chapter 1 and chapter 2, man had no concept of sin, none. Everything was perfect. When they disobeyed God's word, all of a sudden they had the realization that they were naked. Wala tani problema eh. Okay? So what happened? They were naked and ashamed. Di ba? Sa Genesis 1 and 2, they were naked and unashamed. See, that's the life that originally God created. Naguba, ginguba lang sa sin. So what happens? They sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves. Okay, tani, di ba? It looks like an effort. Kasi na-realize sila, naked sila. So they were covering themselves. But in verse 21, God was not satisfied with the leaves. Look what it says in Genesis 3:21. The Lord God made garments of what? Skin. Okay? So there is already a pattern for covering that God is showing in Genesis, which meant what? Which meant a slaughtering of an animal. Okay? To get the skin. God made garments of skin for Adam and his wife, and he what? He clothed them. Okay? So dali pa lang makita natin, ano bang gusto ni Lord? Okay? Tungod sa makasasala ang tao. Okay? Kinanglan, tagaan niya kita sa new self. That's what happens when we are born again. He needs to give us a new self. And now with this new self, He clothes us with this new self. So you see, brethren, the Christian life, it's not self-effort. It's not trying to be righteous. It's walking with God. Lord, when I put my faith in you, my old self died. You gave me a new self, and now you're clothing me with this life. This is the only reason why God can look at us. Because it's a new self, and we are wearing His clothes. Hindi trying hard. Hindi. Ako ang mahatag sa imo. See, God is giving it to us. So all of these things we're reading in what Paul wrote, these are all things that come from God. These are the fruit of our walk with God. So this is not me trying to be compassionate. Hindi. Let's go back to Colossians 3. Because we cannot be naturally compassionate. Diba? So verse 12, put on then as God's chosen and holy ones, he says, put on compassion. Okay? Do you know it is not natural for us to be compassionate? Okay? Dili lang sa church eh. That's why there are so many brothers and sisters in Christ. They need help and they're forced to go to Palawan or Amen. But sino nga nagapalawan ka? Sino? Anyway, Palawan, Luilier, ano pa? Why? Because they go to a brother or sister in Christ. Can you help me? And then they're just saying, ano ka mang tao ka? Oh, hindi ka presa ako na pisan ako nga tao na hindi nga kwarta ko. Nag-work ako para dali, no? Di ba? Nag-asala ka na eh. Paghambal mo, ako nga kwarta, ihatag ko sa imo, oh, di ba? Wala ta compassion eh. No, di ba? You want them to live, give them fish. And teach them to fish, gali. What kind of philosophy is that? That's worldly philosophy. Di ba? Go to the book of Acts. What does it say? Everyone, they did not consider their things, they shared it with others. Grabe. Okay? Yung mga, you want sa, gusto mo umasensyo siya? Teach him how to fish. That's worldly wisdom. Okay? So, compassion, mercy for others, they don't deserve it. But that's why we have compassion. Okay? That doesn't mean we don't teach them how to fish, but we show them compassion. Diba? See? Kindness. What is kindness? It's the act of doing good. Okay? You actually show your kindness to someone humility. Okay? Literally, this is humility of mind. You know why? Because humility is not you look humble, di ba? O tanaw ako, ang life ko subong tanaw, di ba? Sang una muni pero subong hindi na. No, that's just external. Where is humility? It's here. Di ba? Humility of mind. Paul said in Philippians 2, let's look at Philippians 2. In Philippians 2, Paul, in teaching the church concerning their fellowship with one another, he spoke of humility, which came actually from the Lord. Verse 3 of Philippians 2, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit, but in humility, what does it say? Consider others what? Better than yourself. Oh, to dream the impossible dream? Yes. Why? Because no one is better than us. Amen? Kunyari pa ka mo. Okay? Oh, that's why it's so hard to be humble. Because I'm important. Ako dapat ang paminsaron nyo, hindi ikaw. Oh, di ba? Nga nagapakitluoy ka. Eh, paano ako? Oh, di ba? I notice. That's why it's so hard to be humble. Because we're so important. Right? It's true. Put it to death. Notice what the Lord is saying? Put off. Put on the humility. Where does humility come from? Look at Paul's example. Verse 4, no? Each of you should look not only to your own interests, but also to the interests of others. All right? Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself what? Grabe. Now that's an impossible dream. Unless the fullness of the deity is in you. Kuha nyo? You can be humble. How? By realizing the humility of Christ in what He did. Oh, you have a beautiful story of Mary giving birth to a child and growing up to be 12 years old and then etc., etc. But think of it from the point of view of the Christ, of the Son of God. Humbling siya eh. Okay? To become a servant, He made Himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant. Being made in human likeness and being found in appearance as a man. Verse 8, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. Grabe no, humbling, right? This is a working of God, brethren. Doesn't come from us. Meekness. Balik ta sa Colossians 3, Zion. Diba? Meekness. Verse 11, ba na? Verse 12. What is meekness? You know what meekness is, brethren? Many of us, I think that's the reason why when we become angry, we want to shout. Eh. Di ba? Because we think that if we do not shout, or we do not curse, or we do not slander, na hindi makuha sang tao eh. Okay? And then, we're afraid it might make us look weak. Especially mga lalaki. Ah, di ba? Ang mga macho understanding na dapat kita ang ano. Okay? Can you imagine? Ako pinmi ang kinaakigan. Ako naman dapat. That's why may mga ibang lalaki daw vulkan bala, daw taal volcano, kadugay sang pag ano sang ilanga ano kay sila ang gina. Kinanglan humble pero sa sunod galit na galit ka man, one day boom, galupok ka na lang. Divorce na ng annulment etc. Why? Kasi we did not get rid of the old self. Di ba? And we're not putting on the new self, which is Christ. It's not about keeping quiet. Meekness is strength under control. That's what the Greek word means. Okay. So a horse that has been tamed, that is meek. Ano ang meaning sila? Meekness. Strength under control. And the self-control of a believer comes from Christ. Diba? See, you notice, everything we do, brethren, konektado sa prayer ni Paul. I pray that you will be filled with the knowledge of God's will. Who is He? Ano ang connection sa akon nga kabuhi? Si Lord ba meek? Di ba? Si Lord ba humble? Was He compassionate? Was the Lord kind to you? Okay? Don't look at the 5,000 that He fed us. No, to you. Was He compassionate and kind and merciful and humble to you? Okay? Now look at the next. Being, it says, you are to be patient, di ba? Patience. Verse 13, bearing with one another, how difficult is this? Okay? Bearing with one another, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other. What does it mean, before we go to forgiveness, what does it mean to bear with one another? So, kunyari, hindi mo type si, sino kaya ang piliin ko, supong? Okay? Piliin nato ng bisita kay Mapuli naman siya sa Manila. Kunyari, si Eman. Anyway, uuwi ka naman, di ba? Example lang naman. Hindi ko type ang iyang ugali, for example. Diba? You notice ang tendency natin is we want them to be like us. Eh. Okay? Yung mga driver lang, mga driver. Pag ang salakyan sa front mo, kahinay, sa dalaga niya, so binibusinahan mo siya. Tit. Nagadali ko eh. Ikaw nagadali, siya hindi eh. But you notice, we want the other driver to be like us. Sometimes we're like that with people. Okay? Talk si Eman, but di ko, so we want Eman to be like me. So I cannot bear with him. The more he keeps on doing it, ay hindi, dapat magbago siya. You know what the Lord is saying? Ikaw ang magbago. Bear with one another. Okay? Bear with him. Bear with her. Okay? Don't expect others to be like you. Because they're not you. They're not you. Di ba? That's the number one rule in marriage, di ba? Don't make your wife like you. Don't make your husband like you because they're not you. In fact, the husband and wife are a new you. Okay? Don't make rhyme, no? No, it's true. God is not expecting, just because you have the same family name, doesn't mean your wife becomes exactly how you want. No. God has created a new, unique relationship in the husband and wife. Diba? Relationship. So you don't expect them. You bear with... It doesn't mean you don't teach because that comes later on. Pero you bear with them. Be patient. Diba? And trust the Lord to be the one to change them. Diba? Not us. Because they can change externally for you. But they will not be doing it for God. Right? Grabe, no? This is the new self. Okay? This is the new self. This is not, I will try hard. No. It's the character of God that He brings, that He's renewing in you. Amo na ang point ni Pablo eh. See? And then look at forgiveness. Okay? And if anyone has a complaint against another, okay, forgiving each other as the Lord has forgiven you. Okay, that's why kanina I asked you, try to forgive. How many have asked counsel from me? And they always tell me, Pastor, I'm trying to forgive. Okay. No, it's not the point. Okay. The Word of God says, you must forgive. Okay. No, that's what it says, right? As the Lord has forgiven you, here is where you see that this is not morality. Why? Kasi if God does not work in your heart, it's impossible for you to forgive. Diba? It's impossible. What's the philosophy of the world, brethren? Be careful, diba? Kung naging fan ka ni Oprah or any other talk show, anong ginahambal nila? You need to forgive. Why? To set yourself free from the prison of your anger. So for you to be free and for you to set yourself free, forgive. And how many, I watch those shows, not just to compare. How many people say, oh, I followed your advice, Oprah, and now I'm so free na na-forgive ko ng tatay ko. Ang nanay ko na-forgive ko. So mo ka-free sang ako nga feeling. Woo! Diba? What's that? That's worldly philosophy. You know why? Why should you forgive? Why? Ano ang bali Paul? As the Lord has forgiven you. If you have no idea of the Lord's forgiveness, if you have no idea of how unforgivable you were before God, there is no way you can forgive someone. Ang problema ng forgiveness, abi lang nato, oh, ginpatawad ko sa Ginoo, Christian ako. Hindi. You know what that forgiveness meant? That forgiveness meant was what I did to the Lamb of God, I should have done to you. I should have made you suffer. I should have hung you on the cross. I should have slaughtered you because of your sin. Why? Because I'm angry with you. But in Christ, I have forgiven you. And you bow down and say, Lord, I can't believe it. And then as you grow in your Christian life, you meet someone who is unforgivable. And you go back to yourself. And you say, Lord, pinatawad mo ako eh. Unless you see yourself as the most unforgivable person in the world, you will never be able to forgive someone whom you think is unforgivable. Grabe. This is a God thing, brethren. Cannot be understood by the mind. How can I forgive someone who destroyed my life? How can I forgive someone who stole something from my life? How? By realizing that you were that person before God. You were unforgivable. But because of His mercy, because of His grace, because of His compassion, His humility in becoming the Son of God, His patience with us. Diba? How patient was God? Not was, is God with us, brethren? How patient is He? Does God bear with us? Yes. Diba? Have you ever read that psalm? I don't memorize exactly what psalm it is. Diba? The steadfast love of the Lord endures forever. Ano binisang endure? Gapadayon eh, di ba? And even when we become unlovable, the Lord just endures us. That's why the Lord through Scripture tells us, be patient with one another. Why? That's why, importante brethren, amo nang ginambal sa mga ibang nga pastor na, preach the gospel to yourself every day. Okay? Before you look down at someone, before you express your anger at someone, before you ridicule or slander someone, look at yourself first and realize who Christ is. That's the only reason. That's why the Lord said, no wonder when Jesus taught us to pray, when Jesus said, forgive us our sins as we forgive the sins of others, di ba? Tapos nagdugang pa si Lord eh. If you do not forgive others of their sins, I will not forgive you. Why? Because you never understood my forgiveness in the first place. So how can I forgive you of your sins? Diba? So you must, notice what it says, you must forgive. If you have understood the forgiveness of the Lord for you. So if you've never seen that, I cannot expect you to forgive your husband or your wife or tupadbalay nyo kamag-anak mo na ginakaw ang ginkawat ang inheritance na dapat sa imo. How can I forgive? Dapat manggarano na ako subong. Notice, you're setting your mind on earthly things eh. Well, hindi mo siya ma-forgive. Of course, people say, ano ka ba? Diba? Ipaglaban mo na sa court. Diba? Set your minds on the things above. Set your hearts on the thing. And above all these, go to the next verse, verse 14, put on love, ganamin, huh? Which binds all of these things together. Di ba? They bind it together in what? Perfect harmony, right? Ebony and ivory come together in? Wow! Basin next week, mamangkot ko sa inyo pagtika Colossians 3.14. Hindi yung ma-memorize. Eh? Si Stevie Wonder kag si Paul McCartney, kinamemorize nyo. Eh. But look what, the love, the word love, there is the word agape, which was in Greek literature was never or rarely used for humans. Do you know that? In human relationship, it was the Greek word phileo that they used. Every time they used agape, it was either for a god or in Christian literature for God. And yet, it is the same love that is expected from us. Why? Again, our knowledge of God's will. Okay? Didn't Jesus say in John chapter 13, just to remind us, brethren, that the word may transform us this morning? John 13, verse 34 to 35. A new commandment I give to you, Jesus told his disciples, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, so you are to love one another. Here now was a command given on the basis of what Christ did for them. Look at verse 1 of chapter 13 of John. It was just before the Passover feast. Jesus knew that the time had come for him to leave this world and to go to the Father. So having loved his own who were in the world, he now showed them what? The full extent of his love. Okay? Now yes, that is the cross. Okay? He went to the cross, right? Nagpalansang siya sa cross. Antes niya ginhimuna, anong next story sa chapter 13? He washed their feet. Diba? Notice, amo na ang summary sa Colossians 3. Compassion, kindness, humility, patience. Have you ever washed? Okay. Remember in Israel during that time, wala naman asfaltado nga dalan. Eh. Tapos naka-sandals pa sila. Di ba? Can you imagine how dirty those feet were? Di ba? And then Jesus himself washed their feet. Dapat servant, di ba? Ang nag kasi it's a humiliating work. That's why para sa servant lang. And then what did Jesus tell them? As I have washed your feet, ano ang bal niya? So you must, you must wash one another's feet. And then he gives them that command. A new command I give you with this understanding of my showing the full extent of my love and my showing how I washed all of your feet. Now I tell you, love one another as I have loved you. See? By this they will know that you are my disciples. Ambal niya. That you love one another. Have you noticed this, brethren? Yeah. Verse 5 to 7 of Colossians 3. Notice what it is, diba? Diba idolatry ang focus, right? Why? Because it's our love for God. See, that's why, ang tanan nga idols, dapat ihaboy. Why? Because our love for God. Verse 8 to 14, what is it talking about? Anger, wrath, malice, di ba? Compassion, kindness, humility. What is that? Our love for others. Okay? You remember when Jesus was asked, what's the greatest commandment? Di ba? Mark chapter 12, it was asked of the Lord. Verse 28, one of the scribes came up and heard them disputing with one another, and seeing that he answered them well, asked, which commandment is the most important of all? Which commandment? Do not lie? Do not steal? Ano bang pinaka-importante ng commandment? Look where the Lord brings them. Jesus answered, the most important is, that's why it's not just the 10 commandments. Di ba? Look what it was. The Lord our God, the Lord is one. Verse 30, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. That's the great, it's not about lying or coveting, di ba? It's about love the Lord your God. So if you look at the 10 commandments, the first 4 are about God. You shall not use, have no idols. You shall not use his name in vain. You're to honor the Sabbath day that he made holy. Diba? Tatlo lang na. Ano yung pang-apa? Basta the first four. And then the next six in the Ten Commandments is what? It's about others. And that's what Jesus said in verse 31. And the second is this. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these two. No greater commandment. That was the whole point of the commandments. What? To love God. And to love others. What is this new self that Paul was bringing us to? It's bringing us to this. Diba? Everything that God is doing is bringing us back to what He desires from each one of us, to love Him and to love others. Okay? What sa worldly philosophy, ano ang ginkakast nila da? Notice, di ba? All we need is love. Puro ta song subong, no? Tan-tan-tan-tan. Beatles na naman. Anyway, di ba? Kanami, di ba? All, imagine, there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. Oh, di ba? It's all about, anong ginkakast ang kalibutan? What did they take away? Love for God. You see? So everything the world is doing is wrong. But notice how we are fooled sometimes. Sometimes, di ba? Pastor, di ba eksakto sila? Na dapat nga naman may love ta sa isa kag-isa. That's why sometimes confused kita. When we begin to question sexuality, di ba? And, you know, it's their choice na ba na amo ng ilang sexuality. Hindi ba, pastor, ang Kristiyano dapat? Oo nga, compassionate. But that without understanding our love for God. Di ba? You take away the love for God, all other love is wrong. See? And that's why another song that came out was, if you can't love the one you love the one you're with. Okay, no? Di ba? 60 song na eh. Okay? Or 70, so nalipat ko eh. Okay? So, if you're not with the one you love, di, kung sino na lang upod mo. And that's how the world, okay? That's why, what do they call sex? Let's make love. Oh, di ba? Oh, what? Where is sex? Where is the context of sex there? Anytime? With anyone? No, right? For when you come back to God, when you love God, and you understand that this love is what we, the way we love our neighbor is how God loved us. That's the only way that this new self that we clothe ourselves with is able to. Let's end, brethren, with Colossians 1, verse 9 to 10, because that's the whole point. So from the verse 9, from the day we heard, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will, in all spiritual wisdom and understanding. Why? So that we may walk, how? In a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good work. What kind of compassion is pleasing to God? Na basta nagabulig ka, yeah, na ang interest mo hindi 5-6, basi ano bang naming interest? 1, wala ka idea, di ba? Gabulig na may compassion naman ako, gamay lang ang interest, di ba? Is that compassion, the compassion of God? Or is it a compassion of God that is a fruit of our knowledge of His will? Of who He is? Of how He wants me to live. How compassionate was God to me? How merciful was God to me? Do I really believe that everything that I have is His? Diba? If I really believe that, then when we help others, we're not giving them that is ours. We're just passing on what God has given us. Diba? Amen? And with that understanding, that's when it becomes pleasing to Him. That's when it bears fruit in the spiritual realm. Okay? If you look at all of these philanthropists going around in the world, wow, nakakaingit, no? Mayo pa sila. No, that's not the point. The point of the Lord was always, do you love me? And in that love, do you show that to others? That's the new self that you are to bring. Notice how the church was meant to protect that life, eh. Di ba? Sa Colossae, puro philosophies, puro immorality. They were supposed to keep that life strong, continue in the faith. Diba? Brethren, that's exactly what's happening with us today, right? But it's all really in our understanding of the knowledge of who God is and what He has done for us. Okay, let's pray. Let's bow our heads. Lord, thank you for your mercy upon us, and thank you for your compassion, your humility, your love, Lord, your forgiveness. All of these that you've shown to those of us who believe. Father, in this understanding, may we also put on the new self so that we may show this life also to others, O God, that you may be glorified and exalted. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I pray that your word truly transforms each one of us. Wherever your word today is applied, whether to husbands and wives or parents with children or relationships or work, the workplace or in the church, Father, I pray that your word may transform us and bear fruit in our lives, that we may glorify you. Thank you, O God. Bless us as we go, and Lord, we pray that your grace and your love may bring protection upon us always. Thank you, Father. As always, all glory belongs to you alone, Lord. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Let's bless the Lord. Amen.